The first lesson is written in the book of the prophet Isaiah, the 49th chapter, beginning the first verse. Listen to me, O coastlands. Pay attention, you peoples from far away. The Lord called me before I was born. While I was in my mother's womb, he named me. He made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me away. And he said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified." But I said, "I have labored in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing and vanity. Yet surely my cause is with the Lord, and my reward with my God." And now the Lord says, "Who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him? For I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God has become my strength." God says, "It is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. Sing for joy, O heavens, and exult, O earth. Break forth, O mountains, into singing, for the Lord has comforted his people and will have compassion on his suffering ones." Here endeth the first lesson.
Lord.
The second lesson is written in the first epistle to the Corinthians, the third chapter, beginning the seventh verse. So neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. The one who plants and the one who waters have a common purpose, and each will receive wages according to the labor of each. For we are God's servants working together. You are God's field, God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation, and someone else is building on it. Each builder must choose with care how to build on it. For no one can lay any foundation other than the one that has been laid. That foundation is Jesus Christ. Now if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, the work of each builder will become visible, for the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test what sort of work each has done. Here endeth the second lesson. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, on this feast day on which we celebrate your servant George Augustus Selwyn, we pray for all those who follow in his footsteps in pursuit of knowledge and wisdom today. We pray for the staff and students of Selwyn College, Otago, and of Selwyn College, Cambridge, that they may be enlightened and that you may grant them gifts of insight, of wisdom and curiosity, so that they may expand our knowledge of your universe. Ever-loving God, on this day on which we celebrate your servant, George Augustus Selwyn, we remember his legacy as Bishop of New Zealand. We pray that you will give us courage to build on the foundations which he laid, that we, like him, may value the relationships and the mutual trust and understanding between our peoples, that we may honour Pacifica, Māori and Pākehā, that we may weave together the tapestry which you have designed, and that we may build a unique part of your church in a unique part of your world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we commend to you this night all who struggle, all who are anxious, all whose hope is fragile, that they may know your loving presence, that they may be held in your arms, that they may meet in us, your servants. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. On this World Day of Action for Parkinson's, we pray for all who research into, who care for those who suffer with, and all those who experience Parkinson's disease. We ask you to give wisdom to those who seek treatment, to those who try to unlock the secrets of medical advancement. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So we commend ourselves and all those whom we love to your eternal blessing. Mata Maria Tato, Coronea Toya Tefakaro, Tiaka Katanaka, Katahinangaro, Lordia Karaiti, Akimokia Hokikia Kota, Manakia Te Atua Kahara, Atamatua. The Tama to Wairuata, Aine Aki Tonuati. Amine.